What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Bruce Leroy. This is where we're going to start off part two of this Beyond Two Souls walkthrough. It looks like Jody is at the scientist's office or whatnot with her mom, so we're going to start from here. Here we go.
Hello, Jody.
Hello, scientist-looking dude.
My name is Nathan. Nathan Dawkins.
I'll call you Steve.
I thought
Jones.
It would be a good idea for us to have a little chat, get to know each other a little better. That is, if it's okay with you, of course.
All right, let's sit down.
Jody, my job is to study strange events and then try to explain them.
Why are you talking like that?
Like the things that happen around you, right, Jody?
Okay, I'll just agree.
Your mother tells me you have an invisible friend.
Don't we all? Yes, I do.
This friend, has he been with you a long time?
You're kind of creepy. I'm just going to shrug.
Since you were born?
Really? Yes, he's been with me since I was born.
Is he a ghost? Or a spirit of someone who passed away?
Are you being nosy, man?
Can you draw him for me?
Sure. Why not? All right. Getting my Picasso on. You see it? You see it? My artiste.
Mind if I take a look? So, this thing is your friend, and he's connected to you with some kind of cord. Is he here right now?
Yes, he's here.
Can you tell him to do something?
Sure, we'll knock those glasses off your face. All right, you ready for me to do something? What do we want to do?
You tell him what to do, and it happens.
I don't tell Aiden what to do. No one does. He's like a lion in a cage. We're tied together. He can't go away. That makes him really angry. It's not my fault. I want him to leave too. It can be really scary sometimes.
Did he do that to you?
No. That was the monsters.
It won't be for long. Just long enough for them to find out what's going on.
Please don't leave me here.
Just for a couple of days. You'll see. Time will go by fast.
Susan, we need to go. There's no reason to drag this out.
Here we have a better chance of understanding what's happening. We can find a way to protect you.
Nobody can protect me.
Your belongings are in that bag over there. Cole and I are right next door. If you need anything or if anything's wrong, just call and we'll come right away. Okay?
Good night.
All right. Find somewhere to change.
I'll do here.
Hope they haven't put cameras in here too.
Alright, what are we doing? Going to sleep? Let's go to sleep.
Bunnygruff, where's my rabbit?
Can't go through there. Oh, it's in the suitcase. I beat this game already. I don't remember too much any of this. Too much of any of this from PS3.
I'm gonna turn out the light now. Good night, Jody.
Wait! Can you leave the light on in the hall? I don't like it when it's dark.
Sure. How's that?
Good.
Good night.
Night. Don't be afraid, Aiden. We're gonna have a good night's sleep. And nothing is gonna happen. I can't sleep, Aiden. I think I need a story.
Okay. I just want to read you a story. Thank you.
Oh, come on. Nathan, something's happening. Something's happening. Something's happening!
What's up?
Something's attacking Jody and this goddamn door won't open.
Jody! Get a doctor! Hurry!
It's okay. It'll be all right now. Hayden isn't scared of them anymore.
Okay. Little poltergeist girl.
I don't know how to tell you this, Jody, so I'm just going to tell you. Your mom and I, we've been transferred. We have to leave the base. We really want to take you with us, but we think... Everyone thinks that it would be better for you to stay here with Professor Dawkins. Of course, we'll come to see you whenever it's possible. And when you're better, you'll join us in our new home. Okay? Well, I think it's for the best. Goodbye, dear.
How you gonna leave your daughter like that? That's crazy.
Be brave, darling. I know this is difficult. I'm sure it'll work out.
Gotta go, Susan.
Just give me a minute, Philip.
That's enough. Come on.
Thank you.
Jody, we're here. We'll always be here for you.
Listen, I'm not sure. Maybe I shouldn't go.
Jody, you've been begging me for weeks. You're not going to back up now.
I don't know anybody there. They might all hate me and... Stress is awful. Let's just go.
Just take a deep breath. There's no reason to panic. It's just a birthday party. I'm sure everybody will like you. You'll have fun, maybe meet some new friends.
He's not sure.
Go on.
Just being optimistic. All right, let me out of here. Oh, this sedan, I like those leather seats.
Don't forget your present.
Sure.
It's a book of poetry by Poe. It's 50 years old and very rare. I'm sure she'll like it. Don't worry. It's gonna be all right. I'll pick you up at 5. Have fun.
Oh, Cadillac. All right. So, can we look on the inside first? No. I kind of peek the place out before I just walk in there. Can't see in there. Hiding. If I can go in there as hiding? No. Oh, crap. Let me go build. But the neighbors seem nice.
Hey, Jody, come in.
Hi.
Hey, Kirsten, you coming? I gotta go.
Come in, Jody. Don't be shy.
Hey, Jody, right? Come on, we're in the living room. Some girls from my school and the least dorky guys we could find.
Oh, is that a present for me? Cool. Thanks.
I'm off, darling. Look after your friends and don't do anything stupid, all right?
Sure, Mom. Whatever you say.
Finally, she gets the hint. Hey everyone, this is Jody. She's in Unit 4 with my mom.
Unit 4? The paranormal department?
Ooh, what you do there? Bend spoons or speak to dead people? Stuff like that?
No.
Yeah, party time! I'll get the beer. Guys, do the shutters. Girls, do the candles. And Jody, you can take care of the music. Let's get crazy!
Okay. Alright, so... this is where we're gonna end part 2 of this gameplay of Beyond Two Souls. We'll pick up with part 3 from the beginning of this party. It looks like they're playing football in the background on the TV. It's pretty cool. Alright. Till next time. Peace.